Welcome to my channel Traveler Paints. Natalie here. Today we will create a sunset seascape with a cloudy sky. Here you see me laying out the basic composition and also putting some paint on the canvas so that it is slightly wet so that the fluid paints attach better. It's the first time that I tried to apply my paints with a funnel. I've seen that done by an artist that I admire, Emily Meyer. You have to check out her work. She has published a few videos on YouTube and also has an Instagram page and is in a few Facebook groups. And her technique and her very minimalistic, serene landscapes are very unique. I don't think I used this technique the same way that she does. Probably my paints were too thin and not mixed in the same way than hers, but it was still a fun thing to try out. And I needed to make a lot of adjustments, but I'm happy with the end result. At that stage, I found that the blue-gray tones and the orange mixed a little bit weirdly in places and gave you some unwanted green color in the sky. So I had to take away some of that green and just applied more rose color, light pink and orange to make it look better. Most of my paints are paint drippings and leftovers, so I can't really tell you the exact composition. I just threw whatever I had left together. The orange is a house paint that I mixed with pouring medium and water. You find some details in the description box. The landscape is done on two panels, which are supposed to be hung on top of each other. So one panel is the sky and a bit of sea, and the bottom panel is sea and a bit of sand. When working with two panels, it's of course important that the border between the two panels matches more or less. But it's actually not that hard to achieve that, just try it out, it's a fun thing to do. I now work on the sand part. I put down some leftover sandy beige brown with some white and light pink. I had a lot of cells developing in the sky area, but a little bit too much for my taste. So I reported, get more dark clouds, like in the inspiration picture that you've seen in the beginning, which was taken in Pacific Grove near Monterey in California. Beautiful sunset atmosphere with the sunlight coming through the dark clouds onto the sea. This is what I tried to achieve here with my painting. Still found the sky to be a bit messy and busy, so I tried to correct that with a swipe, which didn't really work well because the paints had the wrong ingredients or consistency. As I said, They were all leftover paints and I didn't really know what was in them. So I applied some more neutral tones with a funnel and I'm finally getting somewhere. The sky is already looking a lot more like I wanted to look. Did another puddle pour at the bottom part of the sky to just form a nice big white cloud for some contrast and some light in my painting. Reworking the horizon. Often with these landscapes, the horizon is the most important part. You want it to be straight and you also want it to have some interest. The sand part was a bit too plain. I wanted to look like there were a few puddles of water or some shadows, which is why I applied a bit more color. And some more highlights in the sky. Which was meant to be the focus of this painting. More a skyscape than a seascape. I now use some of the sunlight and sky colors to create a few highlights which are meant to look like reflections in the sea and sand part. But to get waveform, you basically apply some light paint and blow on top of it. That's the method I find most successful. For this painting, it didn't work 100% because I got a bit of color splitting with all the leftover paints, which is why I have to rework some of the waves and also the waveform and shading with a brush in the end. You will also see this brushwork on my video. I now apply my darkest color. It's a mix of Prussian blue and black by Amsterdam. I find it easiest to create some contrast and shading with dark paint at the end of the painting process, after you have already put down most of the other colors. I use my palette knife to do this. The panels are worked on are different sizes. The top panel is 14 times 14 inches and the bottom one is 14 times 11 inches. I find that works well because the focus of the seascape is really the sky part at the top, and the sea and sand at the bottom is just kind of a complementary part to it. The black and blue mix created some nice lacing, but most of it sank, unfortunately, and also split in combination with the blue-gray leftover base paint, so I had to do quite a few touch-ups with brushes in those parts, which you will see later on. Reworking the horizon again, putting down some orange paint and swiping across with the blue and black mix, which created some beautiful cells, which I will show to you when showing the dry result in the end. Creating a bit more highlights and shading. Looks like the panels are matching pretty well. Maybe I gave the top panel a bit more love than the bottom one, but overall I think the composition looks right. Let me know what you think in the comments. The poor part is almost done. I use a heat gun to pop air bubbles. And this is how the painting looked when it was still wet after I finished the pouring. I really like the look, some interesting cells and lacing, some lines in the sea part which look like waves. Some lacing or cells on the beach which look like maybe little stones or a bit of foamy water. Unfortunately, as I already said, some of the paints split, which is why I had to tidy it all up with using acrylic straight from the tube and little brushes. So I used black and blue Amsterdam paint, mixed some orange by Winsor & Newton and some white by Amsterdam. And a relatively small brush, and I just had to mix some more yellow into the orange to make the color more matchy to the orange in the pool. I don't know why I didn't use the house paint, that I used for the pour, for the brushwork. I probably should have done that, but anyway. So I just go over those parts that look messy or that are just not the way I wanted it to look, and correct this with my brush. And this is a finished painting, or maybe it's two paintings, one diptych. These are some details. So here you see the combination of brushwork and fluid paints. This is a part of the sky, this is the clouds, some nice cells there. This is my favorite part of the painting, and this is how it would look in a room. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please give a thumbs up and maybe leave a nice comment, subscribe to my channel and share. Thank you.